We asked our friend Jay Flores, Global STEM Ambassador at Rockwell Automation, to once again join us to talk about the electronic components on the field that keep track of what's happening with the switches and scales and over in the vault.
Let's start with the area every team will become familiar with. Jay, what can you tell us about the equipment in the Alliance stations?
Thanks, Derek. Each Alliance station includes a station control cabinet, or SCC, in player station 2. It includes an armor block input-output module for controlling the LED pendant lights and tells the field when an e-stop is pushed. The SCC also has components to send power and data to the team number signs and acts as the Ethernet interface between the scoring table and each team's operator interface in the Alliance station.
More details on the software side of the SCC and how it operates with the rest of the field management system can be found in the FMS white paper.
What about those cubes in the vault?
The vault uses laser measurement sensors to detect the number of cubes in each column and are accurate to a couple of centimeters.
Lasers? What?
No worries, Jasmine. The sensors are class 1 and safe for the human eye. Each sensor is mounted in the top part of the vault and connects to an armor block inside there too. The distance measurements from the sensors are then sent to the FMS software via Ethernet. That's it for the Alliance station. Let's go check out the switches and the scale.
A small enclosure we call the auxiliary SCC sits in the base of the scale. It connects into the field via Ethernet. It has inputs and outputs that monitor the scale and both switches.
You may have seen some of this equipment before. We use the auxiliary SCC for tracking the gears and spinning the rotors on the airship during first steamworks. And the sensors have been used to count balls in the towers during first stronghold, baskets in rebound rumble, and way back for breakaway in 2010.
That's right, Jay. We're always finding new ways to use these Rockwell sensors. You said those laser measurement sensors are accurate to a couple centimeters, right? I wonder how we could use those again.
I'm sure you'll think of something. In the meantime, if any teams out there are starting to think that distance measurement might be a good feature to have on their robot, check out the Rockwell proximity sensor on first choice. There's a Rockwell limit switch available too that could be employed in all sorts of ways. Good luck this season, STEM Squad.